has...
Grail is the only thing that can save your father now.
Listen carefully, Junior.
Darling, we're going on a journey round the world.
Professor Jones.
Как поживаете?
Hello.
Здравствуйте.
Дорогой коллега, милости просим.
Здравствуйте. Я очень рад вас видеть.
Здравствуйте.
And of course,
Anna.
And this is Miss Helen Seymour. The Akhmatovs are very old friends of mine. It is particularly kind of them to invite us to their daughter's wedding. You will be on your best behavior throughout the whole of our stay.
Yes, Father.
Your very best behavior. Do I make myself clear?
Yes, sir.
Good.
Уважаемые друзья, за Федора Ивановича Маковского. Дорогой друг Федя, за здоровье и счастье наших милых детей. На здоровье!
Это вас!
На здоровье!
На здоровье!
Наш уважаемый хозяин Сергей Константинович Власов оказывает мне слишком большое.
Not another word. Your behavior is intolerable. Now I demand you apologize to your mother this instant.
Sorry, Mother. Henry, we are guests in this house.
Guests, Junior, not rampaging barbarians. Now, until you learn to conduct yourself in a suitable fashion,
You'll stand here in this very spot.
But Father...
In this very spot.
No što bi pravilna paní Agneto, bylo by znát historii mají děla Alexeja Vysarionoviča Makovského.
Na zdravě, na jejich žízi, na jejich zdravě.
Your son.
It wasn't my fault, Mother.
Of course not. It never is. Things just happen. Like the pig you painted purple in St. Petersburg.
Oh, no. I explained.
Or the moose in Murmansk. How could you know he would get stuck in the outhouse?
Right, yeah.
So, what's your excuse this time?
Well, there was a bat.
You were playing baseball in that room?
No, no, Mother. A real bat. I'm serious.
I don't even want to hear about it, Henry.
Really sorry.
Your father will deal with you in the morning.
What's he gonna do?
Have you shot at dawn? I'll provide the blindfold. Well, perhaps it won't be quite so severe, but almost. This time he has gone too far. I just hope his father doesn't go too far as well.
Come in. Helen, what's the matter?
It's Henry. He's gone.
Gone?
A pillow slip is missing and some of his things and that ridiculous baseball glove.
Well, maybe he's hiding. You know, one of his pranks.
Pranks? I'll give him pranks.
Where are you going?
Search every inch of this house. About.
Oh, dear.
Some peasants think they saw him walking through the fields.
How far away?
A couple of miles. We're forming a search party. Don't worry, sir. Madam, we shall find him.
Long way from home, huh?
I'm running away. Sending you your business back to America.
Why are you running away?
My parents drive me crazy. I can never do anything right.
Your parents are here in Russia?
Oh, no, you don't. See, I know what you're trying to do, but it won't work.
Walk to the moon for all I care. I won't lift a finger.
But you're a grown-up. You're supposed to try and turn me in.
I have never given a ripe fig for what I am supposed to do. Not in 80 years. Besides, I'm running away too.
Hooey.
Hooey?
Yeah. Hooey, not the truth. Hey, stay on your side.
Are you calling me a liar?
Not exactly.
Either I am telling the truth or a lie. Which is it?
The truth, I guess, but...
But what?
Well, you're old.
You think only little boys are driven crazy by their families?
We should never have brought him. It'd have been better off at a boarding school back home.
Henry.
Professor, let's not get this out of proportion. Your son has run away, something every normal boy does at some time in his life.
I never did.
Didn't you? What? Not even once?
It wasn't the same.
Such good people. The poorer they are, the more generous.
What are you, some kind of king in disguise or something?
No. I wrote some books a long time ago. They weren't very good.
They weren't? So what's all the fuss about?
They're peasants. Few of them can read. Have you thought about how to get to America?
Stow away on a boat or something, to the Bering Strait.
And then?
Well, then I'd either live with the Eskimos for a while, or I'd get a team of sled dogs and head down into America.
Good plan.
Thanks. Thought of it myself. And you?
I have no idea.
Wait a minute, you're running away, but you don't know where to?
Just running away. I seek a simpler existence. No luxuries, no corruptions. A place closer to God and the soil.
You could come to New Jersey with me.
New Jersey?
Mm-hmm. I mean, if you want. Can't run away without going someplace. I wouldn't mind the company, you know, too much.
New Jersey. Good. Done.
Toast.
They're probably after you.
Oh, yeah, gee, thanks.
Graf Tolstoy.
Vymíňte našli, idite proč.
Mám prekázaná, to jste vyčvaste moje. Vaše semie, bezpokojit se, u vás učit.
Čo s nimi uberajte?
My ne můžem, u nás prekáz.
What's he saying?
They're here to take me back and they won't leave without me.
Well, that's just too bad. Can't go around dragging people off. Free country, ain't it?
Сейчас мы тебе покажем, где раки
зовут. He called you a little skunk.
Yeah, he did, huh? Translate this. Quick!
Давай, лови. Ух, мальчишка паскудный, держи его. Не ори, не ори ты. Где же мальчишка? Где он мог спрятаться? Куда же он убежал? Я не знаю, ищи его.
Sorry. It's just I can't help thinking there are dangerous people out there. Ruffians, brigands. He's only a child. If anything were to happen to him, I'd...
Nothing is going to happen. He'll be perfectly safe.
keepers are still after us. What'd you do? Murder someone? Rob a bank? That's it. I'll bet you robbed a bank.
No, they're Imperial Cossack troops. They're ruthless. The government uses them to rid themselves of certain unfortunate ethnic groups.
Hey, look! They even brought a cannon. Hey, they were calling you Tolstoy. I think my father has some of your books. Didn't you write that really big fat one about war?
And peace.
No kidding. My father thinks you're great.
Your dad's an imbecile.
He's usually not wrong about this stuff. Just ask him.
People assign greatness to that which is mediocre at best. It's a problem.
Hey, they're nearly gone. Let's go.
Yeah, but where are we going to?
There's a train station at Chicano. We'll get there tomorrow.
Yeah. We'll take a train to the Bering Strait.
They'll let us ride for free.
Yeah, I guess being Tolstoy is good for something, huh? Watch out.
I can't do anything. If only I could talk to him. Be with him. Oh, he's impossible. He's so stubborn, so unpredictable, so amazingly...
Amazing?
I just want him back.
Should we stop and rest?
Plenty of time for that on the train. We'll catch the next train.
Sit down. I think you should sit down.
Perhaps. Just for a moment.
Yeah. Look, Cleva. I didn't really want to say anything about this earlier, but... I don't think you're really up for this.
That's gratitude after I got you all this way.
Don't be mad about it.
But why should I get mad? Just because you want to cast me aside?
I don't think you knew what you were getting into, that's all. It's just not as easy as you thought it would be, is it? Last night was pretty scary. For you, I mean, you know, because you're older and stuff.
You're just selfish. You get to run away and I don't. Fine, go ahead. Don't worry about me. I'll just stay here and rot.
You should go home. I'll bet your family's worried sick about you.
The only thing that worries them sick is who gets what when I die.
Oh, come on. Don't you think you're being a little hard on your family? Come on, don't you miss them a little bit?
Of course not. Don't be stupid. Do you?
Who's gonna take care of you if you get sick?
I can take care of myself.
My mother takes care of me all the time when I get sick. You should go home.
I'll go if you go.
Yeah.
I was looking forward to seeing New Jersey.
Me too.
Can I get you something, Miss Seymour? Some hot soup, perhaps?
No, thank you. I'm sorry to be such a burden.
You just rest.
Professor Jones, Professor Jones, the boy, he is found.
Oh! Is he all right?
Yes, ma'am.
He's all right, he's been found. You promise me. Promise me you will not be too hard on him.
Don't worry. I promise.
Professor Jones, Mrs. Jones.
Yes, that's correct.
We were told our son is here.
Come.
Thank you. After you, dear.
I'd like to apologize for running away.
Father? Father?
That's Tolstoy.
Hmm? Yes, sir. He wrote some books once, but don't mention it to him because he gets very annoyed. I guess they weren't very good. Come on, I'll introduce you to him.
Come on! Lev!
Oh, Lev, these are my parents.
Hello.
My mother?
Thank you for taking care of my son.
It's been a great pleasure. He's been teaching me baseball.
It's a great honor. Plenty of time.
Father, why do you always have to be the last one to go to the bathroom?
Junior, the call of nature isn't something that one... Come on.
Hurry!
Jump on! Come on, jump. Right, sit down.
Oh, dear, I'm worried about
it. No, don't worry. If it hadn't been for Junior...
It wasn't my fault.
No, it's Helen. I'm afraid she's sick.
I'm sorry, I thought I was better.
Maybe we should stop over in Odessa.
I mean, it's impossible. I have to get to Athens.
Please don't worry about me. I should be perfectly all right.
Ah, of course, if Junior hadn't chosen to run away...
Why is it always me?
Don't interrupt!
Thank you.
You see the minarets over there?
Couldn't this have waited until tomorrow?
No, that's impossible. Tomorrow, I have to head north. Now, the Parthenon is the most perfect building ever created. Henry!
Sweetheart, I...
Junior, this is not a racetrack.
I don't see what's so perfect about it. It ain't even finished yet.
Junior, I trust that's a joke.
Yes, sir, it is.
Darling, I'm sorry. I want to go back to the hotel, to Helen.
But the Parthenon?
Oh, the Parthenon can wait. It doesn't need me. Helen does.
Just a migraine. A couple of days in a darkened room and I'll be as bright as rain.
Miss Seymour.
Have a good time. I'll give my regards to your sister.
I will. And you have a good time, Henry. And behave while you're with your father.
Not me with father.
Yes. I'll see you both on Monday.
Well.
But, Mother, I thought I was going with you.
You are, Junior.
Yes, I am.
No.
No? So who's looking after him?
Why, you are, my dear. Helen must get over her migraine, and they don't allow children at the spa. I am sure you'll both manage.
No, Anna, this is impossible.
It is impossible.
I have been looking forward to this for the entire journey. I am not staying here.
But I'm going to Kalabaka.
Well, you just have to take Henry with you.
Well, the hanging monasteries are no place for children.
Well, why not?
They're dangerous.
How dangerous?
A monastery dangerous? Really, Henry?
The journey there is even more so.
Sounds perfect. An adventure together.
Yes, an adventure together.
Be quiet, Junior.
What the plank?
Anna, this is my work.
And Henry is your son.
Anna, it's not
enough. You see so little of the boy. He needs you. And anyway, Miss Seymour isn't well. I can't take him, and you can.
Yeah, but it's not.
I'm sure that you'll have a wonderful time. Goodbye.
Anna.
Save me!
Son, that's enough! Now, I will not tolerate you acting like a wild savage.
Yes, sir.
You're an educated young man, and I intend to treat you as such.
Yes, sir.
Now, we will be spending a Spartan weekend translating Byzantine transcripts of Aristotle.
Yes, sir.
And believe you me, I shall see to it you have more than enough work to keep you out of trouble. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
I'll start packing. Right, down you go.
Thank you.
Father, I don't think that he understands your ancient Greek.
Well, he should have understood it. Come on.
The
bet there were lions and gladiators, right?
Junior, lions and gladiators were Roman, not Greek.
Oh, so I'll bet Alexander the Great cut off some poor fool's head right here.
Junior, this was not a barbaric slaughterhouse. We are standing in a theater, a temple of great poetry, drama, and philosophy. Remember, Athens is the very birthplace of philosophy. Tell me, what do you know of Aristotle?
He's dead.
He's dead?
Yeah, he's dead. Stone dead. Just like everything else around here. Dead, 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 dead. All dead. Father, what's wrong?
My son. You call yourself my son, and you say this place is dead.
So what's wrong with that?
A miracle happened here. A miracle mankind will never forget. That's what's wrong.
You did?
Yes, I told you. We're standing in the birthplace of philosophy.
Philosophy, right? So?
So?
So what exactly is philosophy?
Come down here, Junior.
No, I think we should get going.
Junior? You show me some respect. Now, you asked me a very important question. One that deserves a full answer. So come down here. Please.
No, thank you.
Junior! Junior! Junior!
Junior! Look. First you tell me what philosophy is, and then I'll come down.
Well, when you're 5 years old, you asked me questions.
I did?
Yes. Father, what is life? What is beauty? Why are we here? I couldn't answer. I could only think about them. But now you ask me, what is philosophy?
And you can't answer that either.
Well? In Greek, philosophy means love of wisdom. But you could define it as thinking about thinking.
Thinking about thinking?
Yes. Not a science, not a religion. Something in between, exposed to attack from both sides. See, philosophy is a way by which we come to understand our existence and live in harmony with our world. Do you understand?
Not really.
Well, how shall I put it? Over 2,000 years ago, men started to ask the same questions you asked. Why? What? How? But they didn't turn to the gods or superstition for answers, or their fathers even. They looked to reason and observation.
And did they find their answers?
No. And that's why the questions they asked are still with us.
All right, so these thoughts, these questions, are philosophy?
Absolutely. You see, Aristotle is not dead. Nor is Socrates, nor Plato. Everything they thought about is still alive. They gave us the foundations of modern philosophy. Everything that has come since then has been built upon what these men thought. And they thought it here, Henry. Right here. You see, Aristotle was the first to enlighten people to the idea of logic. Our ability to understand the great philosophical question is measured by our ability to be logical. Now, being logical doesn't mean being cold and remote. It primarily means we follow a system of reasoning that draws specific truth from a general truth. Now, he called this syllogism.
What's a syllogism?
Give me that stick. Throw it to me.
There we go.
Father, what are you doing? Father! Father, are you all right? Father! Father! Father, are you all right?
All men are mortal.
I beg your pardon?
Mortal. All men die, Junior. A general truth, right?
Right.
I am a man.
Yes.
Ergo, I am mortal. A specific truth.
All men are mortal. You're a man. Ergo, you're immortal.
All men are mortal.
All men are mortal.
Socrates is a man, ergo Socrates is mortal. Now that is a...
Syllogism.
Aristotelian logic. Obvious, you may say, but think about it. Deductive logic is the key that will unlock the great mysteries of our universe, of our very existence. The questions that Aristotle asked marked a turning point in the history of mankind. An intellectual awakening so beautiful, its day has not yet come to a close. So you see, his thoughts separate mankind from all the other creatures of the earth and make us what we are. We are thinkers, and we must treasure our ability to think.
Father, our cab is gone.
No, Junior, that's our cab over there.
No, Father, that's not our cab.
Son, you're being a skeptic.
That's not our cab.
Yes, it is, Junior.
How can you be sure?
Logical reasoning, remember? Our buggy was parked here. This buggy is parked here. Ergo, this is our buggy.
Oh, yeah, right. Our buggy was tan. This buggy is tan. Ergo, this is our buggy.
Excellent, Junior. Well done. Ambros.
Adam Obama.
Our cab had leather upholstery.
This cab has leather upholstery.
Ergo, this is our cab. Well done, Junior.
Our cab had a driver.
This cab had a driver.
Ergo, this is...
Figate! Figate dedo! Exo! Figato! Figate! Exo!
Father, I really doubt if a bus is even going to come. And if it does, there's probably only one a day, and it's probably already gone.
Junior, you are now being cynical.
Being cynical.
See, after skepticism comes cynicism. Hero made doubt a central issue to all philosophy. And Diogenes became so skeptical of the human condition, he took to living like a dog. And that's where we get the word cynicism from. From the Greek, kinivikos, which literally means dog-like. Legend has it he lived naked in a tub. I told you this would be an education, Junior. After cynicism comes stoicism. Now, stoicism started here too. A determination to live life by its natural laws. I mean, they took whatever nature threw at them. Like me, I'm covered in chickens, and I don't care.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Father, just... maybe we should go back to the hotel.
No, no, we're going to the monastery. I mean, how was I to know the cart didn't go all the way? We'll just get another ride.
Looking like this? Father, this isn't exactly what I had in mind when you said we'd be going on a... weekend-long trip sitting in a library, and it's almost fun.
Well, there must be some water nearby. We shall wash our clothes, bathe, and then continue.
Bathe.
Each species has its own nature, which we need to understand in order to understand our world.
Aristotle, right?
Absolutely. Ah, this is wonderful.
We should be consumed by nature. Watch this, Junior.
I didn't even know you could swim.
There's a lot you don't know about me, Junior.
When I was 5 years old, we used to go swimming in the loch. Now that was gold.
I'd say I had a Spartan.
Father!
What?
You know how you said that we should let ourselves be consumed by nature?
Yes.
Well, nature is consuming our clothes.
What do you mean?
Look!
Hi! Hi, is everybody sit down!
Father, goats definitely do not speak ancient Greek.
Hi, is! Come here!
Father?
Huh?
Are we being skeptical, cynical, or stoical?
Junior?
What?
Shut up. Eureta, Eunuchus. Eureta, Eunuchus.
Do you think they'll stop?
Of course. They'll see us for what we are, rational human beings. Good day! You selfish pigs! Don't these tourists have any compassion?
Father, I'm sure someone will stop. So your name's Aristotle?
Yes. So my wife said, Aristotle, she said, if you don't call that donkey Plato, you're gonna have no one to talk to. No one to talk to. Hey, you interested in politics?
No, not much.
Then you're an idiot.
Thank you, Aristotle.
My pleasure.
No, he's right, Junior. Our word idiot comes from a Greek word, which means one who is not interested in politics.
I'll remember.
So tell me, do you believe in democracy?
Democracy? Hypocrisy. It never existed and never will. And anyone who believes it is a bigger fool than Plato.
Interesting. So Plato was a fool?
No, Father. Plato's the donkey. It's a donkey.
Oh, I see.
Ha!
Hee-haw!
But, this is the home of democracy.
I'll tell that to my wife.
Ah, see your point. But this is the home of democracy, Junior. In Plato's Republic, Plato outlined his ideal city-state. He took three classes: the elite guardians, the soldiers, and the masses. And for these, he gave three structures: monarchy, oligarchy, now that's the rule by the few, and democracy.
What's he talking about?
In the end, Plato decided on a mixed constitution of monarchy and democracy. The rule by the one and the many. A system where the people consented to be ruled by the most qualified.
So, what's your point?
Aristotle emphasized the need for wisdom in politics, not just popularity. He wanted power given to the wise.
No, you're wrong.
But Aristotle said it.
No, I didn't.
Perhaps it was Plato.
Well, Plato said it too, but...
Plato never says anything.
What are you talking about?
Plato's a donkey!
So it was Aristotle?
No. I mean, yes. Democracy. Power should be given to the wise. Now, it's a democratic ideal that still exists to this day.
Like hell it does.
That is what Aristotle wanted.
That is not what I wanted. Sue! 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 That does it. I will not have a raging Democrat on my car trying to put words in my mouth.
Very well. I don't want to ride on this cart anyhow. I'd rather walk.
Good.
Thank you. Excuse me. Come on, Junior. Come on. Junior, come on.
Father, I really don't want to walk.
Junior, you get down this instant.
Father, I kind of agree with what he says. I mean, I don't live in a democracy.
Of course you do.
Well, not really. I live in a monarchy.
You live in a democracy. Now get down.
No, I want to stay here, because if this isn't democracy, then I can stay here.
Malista, bravo.
Junior.
Father, I think that perhaps a wise philosophy might have been not to argue with the driver.
Junior!
Here we are, the hanging monasteries.
It's beautiful.
Good luck, child.
Thank you, Aristotle.
Bye-bye, Plato.
Look, the monastery. How'd they build that so far up there?
Well, son, they used ladders and built big winding mechanisms to lift everything, similar to this cage we're about to go up in. Now, as far as I'm concerned, this is one of the seven wonders of the world. Kalisperas, kire.
Vevaeus.
Pos tha tos afisome na exoronta pame na pano sto manastiri.
Ela, khtipa to kudhuni.
Efaristo ke kalimera. About heights, Junior.
Sorry. Yeah, it's an awful long way down.
Junior, step back.
You know, I wonder if that rope broke, how long it would take for us to reach the ground. Wow. I'd say pretty long.
Professor Jones, good to see you.
Thank you.
I hope that your long trip went very well.
Thank you.
This is my son.
Pleased to meet you, sir.
When I invited your father, I didn't realize he had a son. It is a pleasure to meet his family.
Thank you, sir.
We waited for you all morning.
We got delayed. It's a long story.
Come, sup with us. Tomorrow, the library.
Ah.
It's good you came today, Professor Jones. After tomorrow, we will be cloistered and we'll keep a vow of silence for 2 days.
Sleep well.
Who gets the bed?
Oh.
Aristotle says that man is a philosophical animal. Please behave like one.
I'm bored.
Bored? Bored? We're sitting in one of the most fascinating libraries in this part of the world, and you're bored.
It's also the only library.
I will not have you bored. You will look up Aristotle's Prior and Posterior Analytics in Book 1, chapters 1 to 4 and 12. Then, taking his rules of syllogism, you'll write me 3 pages on the nature of Aristotelian logic and its relation to causality, which you'll find discussed in Books 2 and 3. What are you waiting for?
Aristotelian logiki. Philosophos is it?
Pardon? Oh, ne. O Aristoteles. Sosta.
You are English?
American.
American? Ah, an American philosopher.
Well, my father says that all the good philosophers are dead.
But your father is living in the Dark Ages.
Almost. He's a medieval scholar. Indiana Jones.
Nikos Kazantzakis. Good to meet you, Indiana.
You too.
So why are you trying to read that? Why aren't you out playing?
My father gave me an assignment.
Is this it?
Yeah.
Ooh. The relationship between logic and causality.
He's mad at me. I mean, he knows I can't get it done. It's impossible.
Oh, I don't know. Look at it this way. Aristotle said, nature does not act without a goal. And that sprang from his theories of causality, right?
What is causality?
We have an orange on a pile of books.
Right.
We tilt the top book. Now we push the orange. Push it. Which way did it fall?
Down, of course.
Of course. But what caused it to fall?
Well, I pushed it.
What else?
Nothing else.
Wrong. There were 4 causes.
There were?
Yes. First, the essence of the fruit, its weight. Second, its structure. It is round. It can roll. Third, you pushed it. And fourth, that its function included seeking the lowest level.
Oh, you mean like gravity?
No. I mean its function. The orange needed to fall. Just like a bird needs to fly.
Yes, but why?
The orange needs to fall from a tree to make another tree.
What does that have to do with logic?
You know, a friend of mine wrote a wonderful poem when I first visited this monastery. You want to hear it?
Is it long?
I said to the almond tree, sister, speak to me of God. And the almond tree blossomed.
So, nature does not act without a goal. And, four causes. But what causes nature?
Bravo. That is a question that comes from wisdom and not from logic. You have found the question your father hoped you would find.
I did?
You see, God, the unmoved mover, the prime cause, God dances beyond the bounds of logic. Yes. Well done.
So maybe I am a philosopher.
Maybe you are. Exciting thought, eh? You see, wisdom is greater than logic. But it leaves us asking the question, can you really accept something as being true without any proof? Well?
I don't know.
Neither do I. Yet.
Many thanks, Peter.
Safe journey, and God bless you. I'm glad you were able to finish your work in time. For now, we begin 2 days of solitary meditation.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Good luck.
And where is your report?
Here it is, Father.
Oh. Well, come on, we're running late.
I'm not altogether sure I'd agree with you that wisdom is greater than logic.
Oh, that's what Nikos Kazantzakis thinks.
Kazantzakis?
Yeah, he's a philosopher and a poet.
Kazantzakis? No, he's a romantic.
Father! Whoa! Father! We haven't reached the ground yet!
I can see that, Juniana! Help me!
Yes,
I'm fine.
It's still a long way down, Father.
Hello? Hello?
Anybody there?
We're down here!
Hello? Hello?
Father?
What now?
You're not supposed to have forgotten about us, do you?
Look, Junior, I'm sure this contraption is stuck, and they've gone to get things to repair it. Just think logically.
Probably. Well, then why haven't they, shouted down to us?
Oh, perhaps they don't want to alarm us.
Perhaps. Perhaps the monks aren't even there. Perhaps we got them real angry at us, and they've stranded us down here so that we can starve and die or be eaten alive by vultures.
Please, Junior.
Bet you the first man on Earth probably felt like this. Not even knowing what he was there for. Just think about that.
Would you just please be quiet? There's absolutely nothing to get worried about.
Beautiful.
Junior, look at that.
Yes, Father. It's been hours.
One minute we're safe in a library, and the next we're in limbo.
Father, I'm cold.
Here, Gina, put this on.
Thank you. Father, I'm very cold. I'm so scared.
Junior? So am I.
At least we agree about that.
Henry, whatever happens, I want you to remember something. Oh, no.
Oh, no. Out of the way.
Whose idea was it to light a fire?
Yours.
It was?
Yeah.
Are you all right?
Yes, Father, I'm fine. Never felt better.
This is all your mother's fault.
Oh, don't bring Mother into this.
I'll bring whoever I want into this.
You're the one who lit the stupid fire.
Yeah, but I did it for you.
Totally forgotten us. Maybe they never even existed.
Now let's not lose our heads. Come on. Well, they'll be waking up soon. I mean, it's only been 12 hours. After all, what's 12 hours?
Maybe I should climb the rope.
No, it's too dangerous.
Father, why not? I climb the rope back home at the swimming hole all the time. It's the same thing, it's just a little longer.
I won't allow it. What if you fell?
We have no choice.
Yes, we do. I'll climb the rope.
Father, that's even more dangerous. What if you fell?
But I won't fall. I'll have you know I'm a man of many talents. Climbing is one of them.
We must remember Aristotle's golden mean. Don't be foolhardy and don't be too timid.
Hit the mean by being courageous.
That makes sense.
Aristotle's ethics, logic, and metaphysics had as much of an impact on Western culture as any other philosophy.
Father, are you gonna climb the rope or not?
You have much to learn about your old man, Junior. Your mother's right, Junior. We don't spend enough time with each other. From now on, I shall see to it that we spend more time together.
Jeepers, are you sure that's wise, Father?
Oh, absolutely, Junior. Oh, no. I'm going to vomit. Junior? I can't hold on!
Father! Go slow! Don't slide!
Judas, freeze my hands!
Father, are you all right? Yeah. I told you not to slide.
Yeah, I know, Junior, I know.
Go on, go on, that helps. You'll be okay, Father, you'll be okay.
That's it, Junior. Say your prayers.
No, wait, Father. Be logical.
Logical?
Yes. Aristotelian logic leads us to examine the nature of things, right, Father?
What are you blabbering about?
A ladder is made of wood, right?
Yes.
This cage is made out of wood.
So?
Ergo, our cage is a ladder.
That's not what I call Aristotelian logic.
We need a ladder, Father. Let's turn our cage into a ladder.
Great idea!
Well, these bits of wood should work.
It's Aristotle, Father. He influenced the way we think.
Hurry up, Junior.
In figuring the nature of things helps us better understand the world. Obeying Aristotle's golden mean is going to help us out of this.
There, that should do it. Let's go.
Wait, Father.
Past that brick. Hold on, son. Okay. Not far to go now.
Okay, son. Pass me another run. Nearly there. Come on. Come on. Not far now. Come on. Must have hit him on the head and knocked him out.
Oh.
Espace to Trujali. Trujali. Please, menos to Calathi.
Hello? Are you all right?
Καθηγητέ, είναι θαύμα. Έγινε θαύμα. Θεέ μου, θαύμα. Θεέ μου, θαύμα.
Όλοι είναι κλειστοί στο μοναστήρι για συλλογισμό. Εσύ γιατί δεν είσαι?
Έρχομαι. Έρχομαι. Είναι θαύμα.
Back so soon? I hope you had a good trip. Welcome.
Yes, thank you. I had a marvelous trip. Did you have a good journey?
I had a great journey.
Did you? Was it first class?
First class.
Junior?
Yes?
I don't know how much of this little adventure we should be telling your mother about.
All right, Father.
Jolly good. Here we are, Junior. Right, off you go. Now, remember now, not a word.
Thank you, Doctor.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
What happened to you?
We kind of met some goats. Miss Seymour, how are you doing?
Oh, much better, thank you. I think I may say I'm quite myself again.
Splendid.
And How was your weekend? Did you have a good time?
What would you say, Junior? Did we have a good time?
Philosophically speaking, Father?
Oh, philosophically speaking, son.
Well, I think I'd have to answer that with a syllogism.
A syllogism.
All fathers and sons have good times together.
We are father and son, ergo, we had a great time.
Oh, my heroes.
Way.
My diary's in Berlin.
We don't need the diary, Dad. Marcus has the map.
There is more in the diary than just the map.
All right, Dad. Tell me.
Well, he who finds the Grail must face the final challenge.
What final challenge?
Three devices of such lethal cunning.
Booby traps?
Oh, yes. But I found the clues that will safely take us through. In the Chronicles of St. Anselm.
Well, what are they?
Can't you remember? I wrote them down in my diary so that I wouldn't have to remember.
Half the German army's on our tail, and you want me to go to Berlin? Into the lion's den?
Yes. The only thing that matters is the Grail.
What about Marcus?
Marcus would agree with me.
Two selfless martyrs. Jesus Christ.
That's for blasphemy. The quest for the Grail is not archaeology. It's a race against evil. If it is captured by the Nazis, the armies of darkness will march all over the face of the earth. Do you understand me?
This is an obsession, Dad. I never understood it. Never.
Neither did Mom.
Oh, yes, she did. Only too well. Unfortunately, she kept her illness from me. But all I could do was mourn her.
Okay.
Hi, Grace.
Hi, Professor. Good seeing you.
You're going to be quite a mess, huh?
So what is the significant discovery you wrote me about?
Shh. I'll tell you later.
No, what is it?
No, I'll tell you later. Come on.
This is your great discovery?
It's a bordello. It's just across the border from Columbus. We can be there and back this weekend.
They'll never let us go.
They will if we're smart. Look, I got it all figured out. Here's what we do. Tomorrow at breakfast, just let me... Yeah, it all looks real good.
What did you boys plan to do today?
Not much. Maybe just go swimming.
Good idea.
Ma, we were thinking, Indy and me, of maybe going on a little camping trip this weekend.
Camping trip? What sort of camping trip?
Well, nothing special. Far as Red Butte, maybe?
Red Butte's a fair distance.
We'll only be away a couple of days. And we'll be sure and be careful.
Yes, ma'am, really careful. We'll be back Sunday night, so...
I don't know.
Don't see how they can come to any harm, Grace. What do you say, Professor?
You're back Sunday night.
Then we can go.
I don't see why not. Cora to Wale, Ashmi Philly.
Head to Wale, Pater.
You ready?
Yeah.
Have a good time, boys.
Don't get into any mischief.
We won't. Bye.
And remember, Junior. Back by Sunday.
Yes, sir. Promise.
So you're back from your little adventure. Your room is as you left it. And Junior?
Yes, sir.
Dinner is at 7:30. Sharp.
See, nothing's changed. It's good to be home. Is there anything interesting in the paper?
Not much. President Wilson is sick again.
I heard him speak in Paris. I really felt sorry for him.
No doubt he was deeply touched by your concern.
The treaty was just such a disaster. I think it broke him.
Nonsense. The Treaty of Versailles is merely the latest settlement in the traditional European nation-state conflict. If you'd studied more history, you'd know that.
I disagree.
You disagree? You think this bizarre idea of a League of Nations can ever work? I'll tell you, it's a fantasy. Congress will never vote for it.
Junior, the nation state grew out of the city state, which realized itself through conquest and expanded through colonization. Think of Athens, think of Sparta. The logical result was empire. Think of Alexander, think of Rome. Now, what just happened in Europe was that the German Empire attempted to expand. It wanted territory, colonies, and the only way to get them was through conquest. As a result, the Russian Empire, the British Empire, and the French Republic, which is an empire in all but name, combined to crush it. Russia fell, but Britain and France, with timely American assistance, smashed Germany and restored the balance of imperial power. Now, that is why Lloyd George and Clemenceau are statesmen in the grand tradition, and Woodrow Wilson is an impractical dreamer. That is the historical reality, Junior. It'll never change.
We gave them victory and they threw it away. We offered them a new world and they're building the old one all over again.
Sentimental rubbish. Consider the position of France and England at the end of the Hundred Years' War.
It's different now. Wars aren't fought by knights in armor who go back to their castles when it's over. There's machine guns and airplanes and high explosives and tanks.
The weapons may have altered, not the historical perspective.
Oh, Father, you're wrong. There's a real change coming. I know it. I've seen it. Soon there'll be things you've never dreamed of.
Oh, really? You're an expert then, are you? I decline to continue this conversation.
What?
Be silent.
No, but Father, we have...
Do you hear? I said, be silent.
You're just mad because I left for the war without discussing it with you.
That subject is closed.
It's true. Why can't you admit
Junior?
It? You're still mad at me. And you're going to go on being mad at me, aren't you? You're never going to let it go.
Henry, for the very last time.
No. You'll never change, will you? You can't. You never could. Not even when Mother was alive.
How dare you?
Not even...
How dare you mention your mother to me? Don't even let me hear you speak of her again.
Why shouldn't I? You never did one thing to make her happy, and now you're taking it all out on me.
Why? You ignorant, ungrateful, unfeeling, young...
Unfeeling? I'm unfeeling? No, you're the one that's unfeeling.
You never gave a thought for anyone but yourself.
You're the one that could never admit to being wrong.
You shirked every duty. Dodged every problem.
Fine, well, at least I admitted it. Why can't you?
Took the easy way out. Ran away every time.
Go on. Just for once in your life, admit that you were wrong.
Go to your room.
No, Father. I'm not 10 years old anymore.
You do as I say, son. This instant. Go to your room.
Father, there's something I'd like to say. I'd like to apologize about the other night. The things I said, the way I acted, I was way out of line. And I'm sorry. I guess that's it.
We'll not discuss it further.
Yes, we will. We have to. We can't just pretend that this never happened.
You have apologized. I have accepted your apology. What more is there to say?
A lot more. A whole lot more. Don't you see that we never talk? We're more like strangers than father and son.
Like strangers? You and I like strangers.
It's because we're never close. We're never together. We never have been. Except maybe that time in Athens, but that...
In Athens?
When we went to see the monasteries, just the two of us.
Oh, yes. We'd gone to Greece, if I remember, straight after our visit to Russia. And we got stuck in the monastery's wooden lift.
That's right. It was the best time I ever had with you. When we finally escaped up the rope, I remember you picked me up
and you just held me really tight. It was the only time I can ever remember you actually hugged me. And it felt great. For a while there, just for that moment, you really were my dad. Father, I'm sorry we haven't talked more.
So am I, Henry. Because I know it's what your mother would have liked. And I know, too, that she'd have wanted me to say I'm glad you're safe. You're going somewhere.
University of Chicago.
Chicago?
To study archaeology.
What about Princeton?
The archaeology department's better at Chicago. You said I could decide. You wrote me.
That was a long time ago.
But Father, I...
Very well. That's what you want.
Dad.
Close the door behind you when you leave, Junior.
Dad! You call this archaeology? Get out of there, Dad!
How does one get off this thing?
Where's Marcus? I never told him anything. I just wasn't ready, Marcus. 5 minutes would have been enough.
I've lost you, boy.
I thought you had to, sir.